Mifflin Bulldogs. We the Mifflin Bulldogs. We the Mifflin Bulldogs. We the Mifflin Bulldogs.
M-I-F-F-L-I-N. Mifflin Bulldogs gon' fight to the end. Bulldogging through all the competition. Piling up W's is the mission.
Good morning, Mifflin Middle School. This is Ms. Colson, your principal, and today is Friday, November 6th. I am coming to you from the hallway. Now, this corner is like the Encore hallway. You have the gymnasium around the corner. I'm facing where Spanish would be, and then I have two set of staircases. This staircase is the down. Now, if you notice, we've been talking to you about the signage for social distance. So, stairs down only, except in case of an emergency. So, we had a fire drill. You would disregard the up and down signs that you see around the building when we come back in January. And notice that there's signs all around the building. There's arrows that will show going up, and then it will be arrows showing going down. So make sure that you're paying attention in these videos, and then when you come back, you're gonna see all of this different signage around the building that will give you direction to make sure that we're all practicing our social distancing and staying 6 feet apart. Now let's transition. So every Friday, you know that you listen to a different speaker. And so today, you're gonna hear a message from a college graduate speaking to you on how to be successful and talking to you about the things that you need to do in order to be successful. And a lot of that starts now in middle school. So even though you're gonna be listening to somebody give their college commencement speech, it is very important that you are paying attention, because a lot of times middle school students think that those things are not important. Then they get to high school, and then they graduate from high school, and then they have no clue on what it takes to achieve your goal and to be successful. So let's listen to this speech.
The wisest person I ever met in my life, a third grade dropout. Wisest and dropout in the same sentence is rather oxymoronic, like jumbo shrimp. Like fun run, ain't nothing fun about it. Like Microsoft Works, y'all don't hear me. I used to say like country music, but I've lived in Texas so long, I love country music now. I hunt, I fish, I have cowboy boots and cowboy, y'all, I'm a black neck redneck. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? No longer oxymoronic for me to say country music. And it's not oxymoronic for me to say third grade and dropout. That third grade dropout, the wisest person I ever met in my life, who taught me to combine knowledge and wisdom to make an impact, was my father. A simple cook, wisest man I ever met in my life, just a simple cook, left school in the third grade to help out on the family farm, but just because he left school doesn't mean his education stopped. Mark Twain once said, I've never allowed my schooling to get in the way of my education. My father taught himself how to read, taught himself how to write, decided in the midst of Jim Crowism, as America was breathing the last gasp of the Civil War, my father decided he was gonna stand and be a man. Not a black man, not a brown man, not a white man, but a man. He literally challenged himself to be the best that he could all the days of his life. I have 4 degrees. My brother is a judge. We're not the smartest ones in our family. It's a third grade dropout daddy. A third grade dropout daddy who was quoting Michelangelo, saying to us, boys, I won't have a problem if you aim high and miss, but I'm gonna have a real issue if you aim low and hit. A country mother quoting Henry Ford, saying if you think you can or if you think you can't, you're right. I learned that from a third grade drop, simple lessons. Lessons like these. Son, you'd rather be an hour early than a minute late. We never knew what time it was at my house because the clocks were always ahead. My mother said for nearly 30 years, my father left the house at 3:45 in the morning. One day she asked him, why, Daddy? He said, maybe one of my boys will catch me in the act of excellence. I want to share two things with you. Aristotle said, you are what you repeatedly do. Therefore, excellence ought to be a habit, not an act. Don't ever forget that. I know you're tough, but always remember to be kind. Always. Don't ever forget that. Never embarrass mama. Yeah. If mama ain't happy, ain't nobody happy. If daddy ain't happy, don't nobody care. But you know, I'm trying to tell you. Next lesson. Lesson from a cook over there in the galley. Son, make sure your servant's towel is bigger than your ego. Ego is the anesthesia that deadens the pain of stupidity. Y'all might have a relative in mind you want to send that to. Let me say it again. Ego is the anesthesia that deadens the pain of stupidity. Pride is the burden of a foolish person. John Wooden coached basketball at UCLA for a living, but his calling was to impact people. And with all those national championships, guess what he was found doing in the middle of the week? Going into the cupboard, grabbing a broom, and sweeping his own gym floor. You want to make an impact? Find your broom. Every day of your life, you find your broom. You grow your influence that way. That way you're attracting people so that you can impact them. Final lesson. Son, if you're gonna do a job, do it right. I've always been told how average I can be. Always been criticized about being average. But I wanna tell you something. I stand here before you, before all of these people, not listening to those words, but telling myself every single day to shoot for the stars, to be the best that I can be. Good enough isn't good enough if it can be better. And better isn't good enough if it can be best. Let me close with a very personal story that I think will bring all this into focus. Wisdom will come to you in the unlikeliest of sources, a lot of times through failure. When you hit rock bottom, remember this. While you're struggling, rock bottom can also be a great foundation on which to build and on which to grow. I'm not worried that you'll be successful. I'm worried that you won't fail from time to time. Person that gets up off the canvas and keeps growing, that's the person that will continue to grow their influence. Back in the 70s, to help me make this point, let me introduce you to someone. I met the finest woman I'd ever met in my life. Back in my day, we'd have called her a brick house. This woman was the finest woman I'd ever seen in my life. There's just one little problem. Back then, ladies didn't like big old linemen. The blind side hadn't come out yet. They like quarterbacks and running backs. We're at this dance, and I find out her name is Trina Williams from Lompoc, California. And we're all dancing, and we're just excited. And I decide in the middle of dancing with her that I would ask her for her phone number. Trina was the only woman in college who gave me her real telephone number. The next day, we walked to Baskin and Robbins ice cream parlor. My friends couldn't believe it. This has been 40 years ago, and my friends still can't believe it. We go on a second date, and a third date, and a fourth date. We drive from Chico to Vallejo so that she could meet my parents. My father meets her, my daddy, my hero. He meets her, pulls me to the side and says, "Is she psycho?" But anyway, we go together for a year, 2 years, 3 years, 4 years. By now, Trina's a senior in college. I'm still a freshman, but I'm working some things out. I'm so glad I graduated in four terms. Nixon, Ford, Carter, Reagan. So now it's time to propose. So I talk to her girlfriends, and it's California, it's in the 70s, so it has to be outside. Have to have a candle, and you have to have, you know, some chocolate. Listen, I'm from the hood. I had a bottle of Boone's Farm wine. That's what I had. She said yes. That was the key. I married the most beautiful woman I'd ever seen in my life. Y'all ever been to a wedding, and even before the wedding starts, you hear this? How in the world? And it was coming from my side of the family. We get married, we have a few children, our lives are great. One day, Trina finds a lump in her left breast. Breast cancer. 6 years after that diagnosis, me and my two little boys walked up to mommy's casket. And for 2 years, my heart didn't beat. If it wasn't for my faith in God, I wouldn't be standing here today. If it wasn't for those two little boys, there would have been no reason for which to go on. I was completely lost. That was rock bottom. You know what sustained me? The wisdom of a third grade dropout. The wisdom of a simple cook. We're at the casket. I'd never seen my dad cry. But this time I saw my dad cry. That was his daughter. Trina was his daughter, not his daughter-in-law. And I'm right behind my father about to see her for the last time on this earth. And my father shared three words with me that changed my life right there at the casket. It would be the last lesson he would ever teach me. He said, son, just stand. You keep standing. No matter how rough the sea, you keep standing. And I'm not talking about just water. You keep standing. No matter what, you don't give up. And as clearly as I'm talking to you today, these were some of her last words to me. She looked me in the eye and she said, it doesn't matter to me any longer how long I live. What matters to me most is how I live. I ask y'all one question, a question that I was asked all my life by a third grade dropout. How you living? How you living? Every day ask yourself that question, how you living? Here's what a cook would suggest you to live this way. That you would not judge. That you would show up early. That you'd be kind. That you'd make sure that that servant's town is huge and used. That if you're gonna do something, you do it the right way. That cook would tell you this, that it's never wrong to do the right thing. That how you do anything is how you do everything. And in that way, you will grow your influence to make an impact. In that way, you will honor all those who have gone before you, who have invested in you. Look in those unlikeliest places for wisdom. Enhance your life every day by seeking that wisdom and asking yourself every night, how am I living? May God richly bless y'all. Thank you for having me.
Okay, I hope you got a good message out of that speech. If you learned something out of that speech, email me the top three things that you took away out of that speech. Now, the speech was about 10 minutes long, so hopefully you listened to it in its entirety. I want you all, students, to email me, Ms. Coulson, the top three things that you took away from that speech. Okay, so now we are going to move into my favorite part of Town Hall. Now, kind of disappointed because last week, I tried to switch it up, be a little bit diverse, play some Beethoven Fifth, and all of that, and no one emailed Ms. Riggs. I don't understand what is going on. No one emailed Ms. Riggs, who the composer was, and the title of those songs. Students, we need you engaged. You should have emailed Ms. Riggs, you could have got a prize. But this Friday, I got two songs. Now this is really like you guys' era, because one of these individuals, I don't even know the name of the song or who the artist was. And I can't say it. I'll probably say it on Monday because I was just like, what type of name is that to be calling yourself as an artist? But hey, who am I to judge? You know, read my shirt, see what it says. I'm just saying, I was just like, who thinks of that? So, the first song is a song that was really popular last year. It has two artists, so you have the name, both of the artists and the song title, and one of the artists is a country singer. So let's listen to this tune.
Ain't nobody tell me nothing. You can't tell me nothing. Can't nobody tell me nothing.
Okay, I hope you got that tune. So now let's listen to the second tune. Now this song, I didn't know who the artist was. The song was familiar, but the artist song, name, title, I was just like, what is going on? So remember, you need the title of the song and the artist. And the first person to email Ms. Coulson this week, the song title and the artist for both of those songs, get a prize. So now let's listen to the second song.
Pull you a fool for this.
Oh Lord.
jets and made another one.
Huh? Packing the mail, it's gone. She like I smell cologne. Yeah. I just signed a deal, I'm on. Yeah, yeah. I go out.
Okay, let's see who's going to be the first person to email Miss Colson on one email. Not two separate emails, one email. Song title and artist. And don't forget, for the first song, you need both artists and the song title in order to get credit. Now, neighbor, another fun part of Friday is the Spirit Stick. And this is where we recognize the teacher that has gone beyond their call of duty. They step in, they help and assist whenever somebody asks them to. So now, I'm gonna turn it over to someone from the PBIS committee to announce who our winner is for the Spirit Stick.
Greetings, Mifflin Middle students, families, and staff members. It's me, Miss Ross, and I'm here with this week's Spirit Stick winner. This person was nominated by Mr. Bulldog Entertainment himself. And this is what he wrote. This teacher has been killing it in her online classes. She keeps the students engaged and prepares her online teaching in a way that's easy to follow and makes it possible for the students to understand and retain what she's teaching. She's also not afraid to speak to them on their level. Hello. Finally, because of all the hard work she put into understanding Google Classroom, Zoom, making use of PowerPoint slides, and custom-made graphics shows that she values her students and wants them to be interested and engaged. Without further ado, everyone give it up for the sixth grade leader herself, Miss Nina Lynn. Congratulations, you are the new Spirit winner. Please check your email.
Okay, congratulations to Miss Lynn. She is our winner this week for the Spirit Stick. Well deserving, because I know I find myself emailing, sending it to Lynn's message and saying, hey, can you do something real quick for me? Can you create a Google form? Can you send this message out? And she's always willing. So thank you to Miss Lynn for all the hard work that you do here at Mifflin Middle School. Now don't forget, students, this week was a very interesting week. It was very important that everyone took attendance. And then also, I have been saying in town hall, that's why it's very important for you to listen to the message, that there was no school on Tuesday because of PD, and that your Tuesday classes were going to become your Wednesday classes. I said that multiple days during town hall, and our attendance was very low. Parents, I need your help as well to be engaged in making sure that your son or daughter is doing what they need to do, signing in and checking in, and that they're engaged. And so, hopefully, let's see if our attendance picks back up next week. We've just finished our first full week into the quarter. We're into the second quarter. I sent out a message I talked about yesterday, second quarter Success Academy. I talked about another initiative about Find a Friend. We need all of these things to happen in order for our students to be successful. So please make sure you visit our website to find out this information. Please reference the videos in town hall, and please reference the emails that are being sent to you on a daily basis. And remember, everyone achieves, no exceptions, no excuses. Have a great and safe weekend.